Watch all these, this butterfly is about 12 inches away from me. I got all of them right out here. There's a big yellow and black, or just yellow, mainly yellow one out here. Camera off around my, they almost seem like they want to zoom right by me. Here's that one. That one right there. Where's he at? Oh man. The sun is in my eye right off to my side there, and I can't try to get it focused on these guys. They keep almost fluttering around me like they're not teasing me, but I can't zoom in on them. I'm looking right at them. They're closer than what they look like on the screen here. When I look at them, oh god. Yeah, like here, that's about as close, like it's about a foot and a half, 18 inches away from my face. I'll zoom out so I can get a few of them at a time, because there's like five or six of them out here right now. You got these little ones right here. You see this little one right here? As August gets here, today's August 1st, 2018. Start seeing monarchs out here. Usually I thought it was about the middle of August last year. Usually at the end of the year, for some reason, that's around when the monarchs have been coming out here. I don't know if there's a certain time of the season that they suggest that they come out, but down here in West Tennessee, it's been around the second, third week of August. And these torch sunflowers, which is what this is right here, all these right here become like real prickly. See, this is after they pop, most of the pollen's being taken off. And then they, like here, they're starting to, right here's a perfect one. See how dried out that is? Now those are real prickly. They show you taking tweezers and picking those all out. That's your seeds. Because these large wing butterflies, monarchs, hummingbirds over here, like the honeybees, there's a lot of bees on these too. And you see the butterfly sometimes pop on the far right, where you see there's a butterfly on the right and a honeybee on the left there. All kinds of bees on here. And the butterflies, you know, I'm taking pictures and it's like they're here for me to see them. While I'm taking pictures, they come out here to pose for me. Although they're just out here eating. Good stuff, huh? This is all heirloom stuff. See, again, there's a honeybee right there on that one. And it won't focus good sometimes. Zoom out for it to focus. Jeez. Oh, well. Alligator right next to my face. That's about 12 inches away from my face right here. I zoom out for it to focus. But if I mean, he's not about right at 12 inches from my face. And the bees have been around. I mean, see, people get all afraid about bees and whatnot. Bees don't bother you if you don't bother them. I've moved flowers up with them on there and they'll stay on the flower half the time. Sometimes they fly off. So if you don't swat at them, everything's fine. Because they come in here and this okra is real big right here. Where's that one right here? Yeah. Got his own flower here. See, going right there where that butterfly is. You guys do that on the feeders all the time out front. Bees will take over the hummingbird feeders. It's sugar water, basically. One cup of sugar to 4 cups of water for each feeder. Well, I mean, that's the mixture, and then depending on how much the feeder will hold. We've got probably about 8 that'll hold 4 cups of water with a cup of sugar, and then we got some that hold about half a cup. See, this one's bee even right here, right by my face. And again, I can't focus because it's right there, but I gotta zoom away and make it smaller for it to focus, see? But that's about 12 inches, maybe 11 inches from my face. The camera in between. I think it's pretty cool, actually. It's down here all day doing this. I sit in the house and I watch these, and my wife's like, there's butterflies all over out there. There's a bunch of them. And I said, yeah, there's usually two or three, but now there's probably about 8 of them, 10 of them out here right now. And a lot of bees, honeybees. Enjoy, folks. Enjoy. Try to give you guys something to keep nature going somewhat out here. See, the bees are even getting inside the okra flowers. Let me get out of this because I'm surrounded by... Oh, shit. That was an okra that was going on. I cut it down because I need room to get in here. Got that green okra right there to my right. See the okra right there? About 2 inches of those pods. Tomorrow it'll be 4 inches at least. There's a small red one in there, but I can't see no flowers on this okra. They're opened up usually in the morning, you see them. If I, and I don't see any now. Huh. Right there's one of the flowers, so. I don't know if it's coming in. I can't see on this viewfinder. I think that's it right there. Yeah, the flowers must close in the evening because they open up and you can see right inside and the bees go inside there. The hummingbirds will go in there. Hummingbirds love these too. Plus they got all the sunflowers around us. And then you got Monsanto poison 35 feet off of the garden, 30, 35 feet. I won millions, I would go someplace where I would be away from as much Monsanto as I could. Been getting the hell out of these zucchini out here too. My wife picked about 8 of them. Took them down to a neighbor. Look, there's 2 more yellow right there growing. See those 2 zucchini right there? See the flowers right there, the blooms? Yeah. Next year I learned too, we'll have 2 zucchini plants, maybe 3, but right now there's 6 out here in 4 holes. I'll just put 3 out here spread out. There'll be 2 green and 1 yellow, and that'll probably be too much actually, but really. And the okra too, be 2 or 3 green okras and 1 burgundy, and that's it. See, this is was not purposely planted here, this torch sunflower right here. That's where the 144 garlic we had planted, and we've got about 120 out of there hanging in the shed right now. This is the other lilies we got growing here. These just come up, man. We didn't plant these. They just started coming up 1 year. Over in the front yard, there's a bunch of them got knocked over from the winds last night, the storm that blew up. There's some of them, I don't know if it'll show on the camera. There's like 10 of them, and there's a bunch of them laid over to the right, over that way. And then these here, over here, right next to the garden. Like I said, they just start coming up. And there was 1 here, over here, and there were 2 over there. Now there's 10 over there, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 here. Not all of them are opened up even, so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11. But this is something else, man. This is like what I would say closest to nature, considering, you know. We're in the country. We're not in that much country. We're in Monsanto hell right now. Purple-hulled peas, I've been picking the crap out of them. There's still some on here. See, like this here. This isn't quite ready. A lot of people let them get dried out on the vine. I just let them get all purple, and then I pick them. But like I say, some people let them go all the way until they get dried out. And like I say, with insects and ants and whatnot, well, ants are insects out here. I don't want them to stay like that. Those are black-eyed peas all in there. That was a black-eyed pea, 2 black-eyed pea plants over there together. The tomatoes, brown spot devastated them. We got quite a few tomatoes, but they're all about the size of in between a golf ball and a baseball, and a couple that are about baseball size. But look at the leaves. They've been decimated. I've peeled off leaves from the brown spot that's in these trees right here. You know, I get into this garden over here. See, we can't help anything. We can't control that. That's what happens when you live on someone else's property. When you can't tear down these trees, or you don't have better trees around you, or more trees around you, or what? You don't have toxic poison 35 feet off of the food that you're growing. You have no control over that. So, oh boy. Yeah, so this is where the garlic was. Oh, now it's all grass. Yeah. God, with the sun out here, it's hard to see. And then looking on the viewfinder, I can't see anything on this viewfinder. We've had a couple zucchinis come out of here bigger than my forearms. My forearms aren't big, but you know, a zucchini, instead of one of those small ones about the size of a big dill pickle most people buy in the store. See, there's like melons. Again, I don't know if it's coming out here. I can't see on the viewfinder, but there's a melon down there somewhere. See right there? Some of these have been cut up because, look at, it's too close to the edge here, the plastic, where they were growing too close to the edge. So the grass, we couldn't cut real good, and then when we did, I think we cut some of the vines. Those look like three straight eight. God, yeah, I think right there, three straight eight cucumbers. And I got a couple cantaloupe in here yet. One there, that'll be picked in a couple days maybe. The real big one in there, there's one in, I mean, you can't really see on here, but there's a bunch of big ones out here still. So, in about 2 weeks from now, this, most all this, 80% of this going that way is going to be tore up. Or I don't know if it's insane. I'm going to tear up parts of this because I'm going to plant beans, but I'm going to make sure I go at least about a foot and a half, 2 feet northward from south. This is south, closest to me, and north that way, and there's about 34 feet going that direction. So that's more than enough space so I can go in from here. Plastic actually comes up underneath me about 4 inches, 5 inches. The grass is on top of it. And go in, so about right there. So it's about maybe two feet into the plastic. And then it'll grow and it'll still stop before it gets to the edge down there. And just have a bunch of beans from west coming this way. The tomatoes, you can see that, I don't know, I'm gonna see if you can see that melon down there. I can't see even the viewfinder here, but there's one down there somewhere, shining. Anyway, there's one, you can see that. I think I can see that one right there. Right there. But these are cherry tomatoes that got overtaken by these, the vines from the city over. And there's nothing I can do but because they just grew too close and too fast. And you see how close this hole is to the plastic? That right there is about 18 inches from the edge, maybe 20 inches. I'm going to go from where that tomato plant is right there. So that's probably about 4 feet into the plastic, actually. And let the beans grow north. And it'll have more than enough space. You can see the brown spot decimated these tomato leaves. Trying to get these tomatoes off. When they start turning yellowish, I'm taking them off and going to the house. Let them ripen in the house. It's fine. There's one down there. It's a bad one, though. That red one. See, some of these will be picking the next day or two. The biggest ones we got on here, but next to the house is a plant that we didn't plant, but it came up and it's got better tomatoes than anywhere else. So brown spot has decimated these tomato plants. It's Charlie Brown Christmas trees, because I had to peel off the brown spot. Look at that one. That's a joke. That's an absolute joke. Got a tomato on it. See, these are all going to probably get wasted. I don't think they're going to. They got time, maybe 2 weeks. If I can go to the third week of August, I'd like to do that and let these grow. I'm really anxious to get the beans started. See, here's the big one here. You couldn't see it from over there.